Peace, this is God Lock him all law. Like to give a shout out to Irvin J Productions. Well, the difference between the industry now and when I first started, it wasn't this big billion-dollar entity, number one. You didn't have, you know, corporate America didn't have any claws in it as much as they have now. And it was a more of an appreciation for the culture of hip-hop. You know, the culture of hip-hop consisted not just rapping. You know, it was rapping, DJing, breakdancing, graffiti. It's a way of life, the way we talk, the way you stand on the corner. Like, you know, the Nation of Gods and Earth has always had an impact on hip-hop culture. Peace. You know, we've always been around this culture, because you figure this culture was born in the late 70s out of the streets of New York, you know, and the Nation been out there since, you know, 63, 64, so the brothers been doing their thing out there, being positive and being, you know, productive within their community. So when the hip-hop thing came about, you know, the Gods always been active in it, and you got even before then, you have brothers like you had the group GQ, who made that song Disco Nights, big disco record. A lot of people don't know that GQ represented God and Queen. Those were Gods in that group. You had another song called Jamaica Funk. You had brothers that was down with that group as well. And then you had a world famous Supreme Team show with C. Divine and Justin Law. And this like goes back into like build wisdom, build understanding. So we've always had our hands in on this culture, but that's one of the major differences I see in hip hop as opposed to when I came out, as opposed to now. Also, I came out at a time where it was a real strong black power movement going on. You had your Public Enemies. The culture was live, man. People were really into black power at that point in time. People were wearing, instead of, you know, the ice and the jewels, brothers were walking around wearing African medallions and things in that nature. So, you know, you seen it go from being real conscious and culturally, you know, culturally active, as opposed to now it's like it's this big money mogul right now, and the consciousness is still out there. However, you got to go through a lot of different channels to hear it, because you know the mainstream corporations that control radio, video, TV and things of that nature, they not out here to promote truth and righteousness, you know what I mean? So it make it harder for brothers like myself, you know, to get our music out there. However, sound travels fast and the king's wisdom is going to always be heard, you know what I mean? So you know, if you a diehard hip-hop fan, you gotta go to those outlets where, you know, the real is out there, you know. But I like hip-hop now, to this day, like some of the new artists that's out there, you know. If it sound good to me, it sound good. I don't discriminate, no matter where it coming from, you know, because the original man been everywhere on this planet, so I don't get into the different regions or where you from. Rakim summed that up years ago. He said, it's not where you from, it's where you at. If you were the lost truth, then you with me, you know what I mean? Well, I got introduced to 45 King, had to be around 82. I met him through a mutual friend, his brother named OP. He was living up in Irvington, and he used to be doing beats and stuff. You know, I always heard about this kid, DJ Mark. So I went over his house, and you know, he was sharp. He was known for spinning 45s and things of that nature, and he would invite Tito from the Fearless Four over to his basement a lot. And Tito would be over there just rhyming while Mark is cutting up beats and things. So I actually met 45 King in 82. I didn't link with him until after I graduated high school, around 88. I was messing with Biz, actually. I was rolling with Biz while he's working on the Vapors album. And Biz was gonna put me on. However, I was an eager beaver. I was ready to come out. He kept telling me, yo, wait, just wait a minute. Let me finish the Vapors album. I'm like, nah, yo, don't you know 45 King? He was like, yeah. So he connected me with 45 King. I linked with Mark, and the rest is history. Once I got with Mark, that's how I met Lati, Apache, Chill Rob G, Lord Alibaski, Latifah, Nikki D. These are the original Flavor Unit members, you know what I mean? And it was a beautiful thing, man. We all used to go up to 45 King House in Irvington, And we would just be in the basement, we smoking our trees, drinking, and we would rhyme and brainstorm. And they had an idea to come up with a group, and they was calling it the Flavor Posse, because back then you had the Juice Crew. The word posse was like large back then. But me being a member of the Nation of Gods and Nerfs, I put a little twist on that. I was like, nah, we shouldn't call ourselves the Flavor Posse. I said, let's call ourselves the Flavor Unit, because unit is the root word of unity. And unit is a chain, you know what I mean? Something that's linked together. So I said, yo, we're going to come out like this, the Flavor Unit. And everybody agreed that that would be the name, and that's how you got that together right there. I think we brought to the game like different flows, you know what I mean? We brought to the game, we let the game know basically in hip hop, because at that time it was predominantly a New York thing. However, Jersey been active in hip hop for years. Don't get it twisted. I mean, you gotta go back to like the early 80s. You had Cheese in them from out in Plainfield. They had a hit record that was playing on mainstream radio. You had, when I was a freshman in high school, my man Lil Seth, they call him Lil Seth, was 7 in Hardware. He was down with this guy named Hassan in 7-Eleven. They had made a record years ago, the Fresh MCs, F-R-E-S-H, yo, that's Fred. Them brothers from Peaceland, from the Patterson, and Jersey City was always active with hip hop. Awesome Tool, the list goes on and on. So, Four Righteous Teachers, I mean, a lot of us, we came later. However, I'm talking about like before Bill, before 88, I'm talking early 80s, like 83, 84, 85, 86, you had groups from Jersey that was coming out. So what I think the Flavor Unit brought to the game was different flavors, because all of us had different flows, different, you know, flavors. However, they saw unity within that. And I think that's what we brought to the game with a, you know, with the 45 King, his beats, his line, his way of doing production. You know, he was known for good kicks and snares. He actually taught me the value of a good kick and a good snare. And that's how I got into producing beats through him, you know. But that's what, you know, basically what we brought to the table, you know, besides me being the only god in that, you know, within that circle, you know, I came out straight hitting them with the lessons, you know what I mean? Because that's all I knew. I was a little fiery fireball at that point in time. And what I had, I gave it up to the best of my understanding, you know what I mean? I got knowledge of self when I was 13, no free understanding that. So I've been standing under this for understanding that a cipher for years, and I'm gonna let my understanding as ciphers, you know? And
that's what I'm about. Who gave Queen Latifah that name, Queen Latifah?
Well, the Queen title came from me, definitely. Now, Latifah, that's the name that she accepted it. She accepted it wholeheartedly, because they had a lot of respect for me, God, and what we were dealing with, far as being a member of the Nation of Gods and Earth. She saw that I was a positive brother, and I built with her briefly on numerous occasions about, you know, what we deal with in the Nation of Gods and Earth. She never accepted our culture, and, you know, accepted it far as to be active with it and live it out. However, you can hear through some of her rhymes the influence that, from me being myself, existing in myself and shining light, you know, just building, you don't pick up on certain things. It's just like, you could take a young kid, and he may never accept this knowledge. However, if he's around us, he's gonna hear the language. Eventually, he's gonna be familiar with the language and the culture. You know what I mean? Exactly, and you see that influence in hip-hop in general. Like, a lot of these people running around now, they call Jersey New Jerusalem. They don't know that's coming directly from our lessons that we study. You know what I mean? That's the fifth degree in the Lost Found Muslim lesson number one. You know, and that's where we get that from. And the science with us calling New Jersey New Jerusalem is, you know, the holy city of Mecca is the holy city of the East. We had a wise scientist throughout our history named Melchizedek. He commissioned the three wise men to build the holy city of the West. That holy city of the West that they built was Jerusalem. So the Father, he ordained Mecca, Manhattan, as the holy city of the East. So when the gods came out here, they brought the knowledge, brought Black Seed from Medina named Knowledge God. Matter of fact, he's the one that brought the knowledge to Jersey. this is the holy city of the West. You know what I mean? If you look at where Manhattan sits from Jersey, we are west of Manhattan. So New Jerusalem is the holy city of the West that we striving to build now. And it also comes from Jebus, Salim, and Ariel. When you combine those three names together, you get the word Jerusalem. And it was me, and it was founded. It was built first by the original man. It's a name which means founded in peace. You know, it's a name given by the Jews. However, we the original man. You know what I mean? I said, God, I'm the original man, dog. You know, this is the city that we striving to take back from the devil. That's why we named North New Kingdom. Me and the gods out here, we're bringing about the new kingdom of this land. You know what I mean? They used to look at it as new art. Like I was building with a brother recently at the Show and Prove. I told him, nah, God, it's the new kingdom, because it's a known fact that Allah makes everything new. You know, in a lot of Elijah Muhammad's writings, he mentions that. He said, Allah makes all things new. So this is what we striving to do out here. We striving to make a new kingdom of North, you know. Very little. Actually, I'm in tune more with her mother than I see her, because she's out in Florida. I mean, she's this multi-millionaire right now. She has a lot of businesses and companies going on. Sister doing her thing, and I wish her all the best of luck, you know what I mean? And nothing but success, you know, but I don't stay in tune with her like that now, Cypher, you know. I'm in tune with Lati, that's Apache's brother. I'm in tune with Chill Rob G. I stay in tune with Lord Alibaski, Double J, and I stay in tune with 45 King. And Nikki D from time to time, but I'll never hear from Dana though. I see her mother more than I see her. Yes, man. It's like once you're involved with that, it never goes. Once you got it, it never goes nowhere. Hip-hop is in my chromosome. I'm constantly writing rhymes, producing beats, developing new artists, so on and so forth. So that's something I'm going to always stay after.
Last words, Pilot Force Productions, Block Kim Shabazz, or Urban J Productions. Check this video out on my website, www.pforceproductions.com. Check it out. Peace. God, Block Kim Shabazz. Stay tuned. Peace.
Peace.